Hi folks, hey, it's Pete Bernard here. I've got another great message for you today that I have titled True and False Conversions. Oh, you may think, all right, what are we talking about, hey Pete? But I'm just saying, you know, there are many sitting in church right next to you that may not be saved. They think they're going to heaven, but are probably not. Now just give me a minute. And let me show you through scripture what I'm saying and determine for yourself if you believe what I'm saying might be biblical. Now, today's Christians have been duped by so many false teachers. They don't know what to believe. They are told, come to Jesus. He loves you. He wants to bless you. You'll have a great life and God will take care of you. You'll go to heaven and live happily ever after. Hey, that sounds great, don't it? The problem is that it's really not biblical. Now, when someone comes to God under these terms, expecting a great life, and they are not told that they are sinners and already condemned to hell, they do not confess their sins to God. They have no true repentance, and they do not turn from their sins. They think it's okay to continue sinning. They say, after all, I'm forgiving, right? And some say, well, all good people go to heaven, and there are many that think this way, and many say, I believe there is a God and good people go to heaven and bad people go to hell. The only problem with that thinking is that they are using man's understanding of good and not God's. And what most will say, well, I haven't killed anyone or robbed banks or I haven't raped anyone, so I'm a good person. Don't I go to heaven? God will accept me. Now in Matthew 19:16, a rich young ruler came to Jesus and said, oh, good teacher, what good thing shall I do that I may have eternal life? And Jesus said to him, why do you call me good? No one is good but one, that is God. Now, what do we get from this statement from Jesus? Hey, what he says, no one is good but God. The Bible says we have all sinned and fall short of the glory of God. So you can't get to heaven on your goodness. Jesus went on to explain to this man that he must keep the commandments of God. And Jesus tells him in verse 21, hey, you know, if you want to be perfect, go sell what you have and give to the poor. And you will have treasures in heaven and come and follow me. But you see, what this is Jesus teaching us that, you know, this prosperity message that some teach, it's not biblical. God knows it's better to not have riches. So Jesus is saying he wants you to give to the poor. Jesus said it is hard for a rich man to get into heaven. And Timothy 6:10 reads, for the love of money is the root of all evil. God knows if you have riches, you would rather pursue money than God. Now, let me read you the parable of the sower from Matthew 13:3-8. Now our sower went out to sow, and as he sowed, some seed fell by the wayside, and the birds of the air came and devoured them, and some fell on stony places, where they did not have much earth, and they immediately sprang up, because they had no depth of earth. But when the sun was up, they were scorched, and because they had no root, they were withered away. And some, they fell among thorns, and the thorns sprang up and choked them. But others fell on good ground and yielded a crop, some hundredfold, some 30, and some 60. Now let me explain. The seeds that fell by the wayside was those where someone hears the word of God, but they did not understand it. They don't read their Bible. They are the ones sitting in the pews, daydreaming while in the middle of a service, keeping the eye on their watch, waiting for this thing to be over with. And Jesus says, it is Satan that comes and steals what little they have heard to ensure that they stay lost. Now the seed received on a stony place is like the person that hears and receives what was said with gladness, and for a while they are followers of Jesus, but they have no solid root in themselves and can only endure it for a little while. And then when trouble arises or people make fun of their faith, they lose heart and they stop following God and they fall back into their sin. But they may still be attending church, but they have lost true faith and commitment unto God. Now the ones that receive the word of God that fell amongst the thorns are like the ones who hear and receive the word of God, but it was of the false prosperity message. They had high hopes of getting rich and receiving such blessings from God that this is all they care about. and the cares and the deceitfulness of riches choke the word, and they become unfruitful. Now Jesus said in Matthew 7:19, every tree that does not bear good fruit is cut down and thrown in the fire. In other terms, you ain't getting to heaven, my friend. But there are many that follow this prosperity message, and it isn't from God. Now, lastly, we have the seed that was sown on good ground. They are the ones that hear the word and understand what it says. They follow the command of God. They read their Bible. They pray for that understanding. And it is he who indeed bears good fruit. And the Bible says some 100, some 30, some 60. What this is meaning, some will do the work of God, following his commands and going out and preaching the gospel of Jesus Christ unto the world, and will lead others to Christ. Some many, some few, but you must do your part, what Jesus has asked you to do. Now, the question is, how can you be sure that you are the one that where the seed has been sown on good ground? Test your heart. Ask yourself some of these simple questions. Why do I believe? Is it for the blessings you were promised? Do you think that if you give money to God, you will get back much more, as many teach? Well, yes, this is in the Bible, but should not be the reason why you believe. The motivation behind your giving determines whether God will bless you or not, and the blessings may not be monetarily, as some think. But that's a whole different message in and of itself. Let me tell you why I believe. I was a sinner and will face the wrath of a just and righteous God who must punish all sin. I believe because I do not want to spend eternity in hell. I confess my sins to God, believe on Jesus, and follow him as I am commanded in the Bible. The blood of Jesus cleansed me from all sin so that God will not find me guilty on judgment day, and I will be accepted into his kingdom for all eternity. That is my hope and my reward that I seek. Another question, why do I go to church? Well, are you in church because you think that God's checking attendance, or perhaps you think that going to church ensures entrance to heaven? Some think that if they work for the church, they have an in with God for sure. No, none of this is biblical. God don't care about your attendance record. Being there doesn't save you, nor does working for the church earn you any salvation at all. You already know that if you have followed some of my other messages. We go to church for fellowship with other believers, to learn of God, to help the body of Christ. Some people need encouragement. Life can be tough at times. We Christians must bond together and work together to accomplish the work of Christ. Many believers are new and their faith is a little bit weak. They need help. They need nourishment from the teachings of the Word and encouragement from seasoned believers. Unfortunately, finding a good Bible-based church that teaches the full counsel of God is a different story. Most have gone the way of the seeker-sensitive message, only preaching what people want to hear, or others have made up their own beliefs that aren't scriptural at all. Stay away from such church. They will drag you to hell with them. It is not of God. The gospel of Jesus Christ must be the primary message if we're going to sow seed on good ground. If a church doesn't follow the Bible, that is the very word of God, but believe they know better, stay away. Do not put your faith and trust in them. They will let you down. Read the Bible for yourself and know the truth, and the truth will set you free. Now, another question might be, am I ashamed of my faith? I pray not. Jesus said in Luke 9:26, if you are ashamed of me, I will be ashamed of you before my Father. In other words, Jesus is going to turn his back on you and you aren't getting into heaven. Now, as for me, I have had to learn not to be afraid. You see, we naturally fear rejection and ridicule, so we have a tendency to hide our beliefs, thinking it's okay. Yeah. Nobody needs to know I believe. Yeah. Yes, people think that I might be a Jesus freak and a fanatic. So what? I'm just doing what Jesus asked me to do, right? Another question. Does anyone know at your place of employment that you're a Christian, and do you know whether they are or not? That's a good one. Yeah, since most people do not share their faith, of course, nobody knows what they believe. Nobody's talking about God at work, so how are you to know? I have worked with people for years before I have ever heard or seen the slightest indication that they believe in God. Then I wondered, what do they think about me? Can they see by my actions that I'm a godly person? Have they heard me cuss or be angry, or can they see the fruit of the Spirit of God in me? Yes, we can't go around preaching Jesus all day. We have work to do. But you can act in a godly manner. But you must ever be on your guard. It just takes one slip of the tongue to ruin your witness. Now, a last one. Have you shared your faith with anyone? One of the most difficult things any Christian will ever have to face. Very few will ever gain the courage to do so. We have a genuine fear of rejection. We would rather do nothing than to face rejection. Jesus said, "If you love me, keep my commandments." One of his commandments was, "Go into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature." And he said, "If you love me, you will keep my commandments." This is what we must do as believers, whether we like it or not. People are dying out there, and they're not hearing the gospel of Jesus Christ, and you're letting them go to hell. What I'm saying is there are true Christians who have truly repented and trust in Jesus as their Lord and Savior. But there are also those who are deceived into thinking that they can have a Jesus as Savior without having him as their Lord. And there are many that will find themselves one day calling him Lord, Lord, on the day of judgment. And Jesus will say to them, "I do not know you. Depart from me, you worker of iniquity." Why is this happening? The modern church is feeding a different Jesus to them. They say that Jesus will provide peace and joy and love and fulfillment and everlasting happiness. To many, the gospel has become a heavenly offer to give us a happier life than the one that we have without God. The contemporary preacher teaches principles of daily living. They tell you how to find victory over your life problems, how to advance in society, how to make your marriage work and get along with others and raise your kids. But they don't talk about the heavier issues of sin, righteousness, and judgment. Society has no true fear of God. The reason that humanity has such a propensity to do evil that there is no fear of God before their eyes. If there is no fear of God, then there is no fear of the consequences of sin. They have no fear of the judgment day or of the eternal damnation in hell. Without the fear of God, there is no restraint against evil. The church needs to get back to the basics of the gospel of Jesus Christ. Teach man that he is a sinner using the law, which is the Ten Commandments, and the law will do its job and convict the heart of sin. Allow true repentance. Teach that we are to trust in the sacrifice of the cross. Jesus paid the price for our sins if we accept and believe in him. God will find us not guilty on Judgment Day. Then accept him as your Lord. Follow Jesus and keep his commandments. And I mean all of them. So this is Pepinard. I hope you have found this message useful. And we'll take a closer look at your relationship with the Lord. We only get one chance at this life. Don't be found to be the one that Jesus does not know. And may the Lord Jesus open your heart to know the truth. So please give me a like and a share, and you can always find me on YouTube. Just look up Peter Bernard. You'll find me there. And God bless you.